I just want to say something. As we proceed in this service, you know, people, ministers get scared when imagination. But let me say something here, because the power that is in that place, we are not tapping into it. Dr. Paul Yonggi Cho said there was a gentleman who had an accident. Well, to cut long story short, he was put into the hospital and he was in a state of coma. He said he asked God, just bring him back for 5 minutes and he'll get. The man came back. He said, what will you have been doing if you were not on this bed here dying? He said, I'll have been going around the whole place taking my children. He said, imagine that. He said, just picture that while I do the prayer. He said, keep that image face before you. He said, he started praying. The entire room got heated up. The nurses came in and said, what's going on? There's fire, fire, fire. Listen, no. I read it, so I went to test it. I went for a very small fellowship. It was called Yeshua Fellowship. In Ibadan. We're very small, we're like 30. So I decided to worship God. So I took the revelation of God that I knew and I painted the picture. As I was worshiping, when we finished the fellowship, people came to meet me. Said, what was going on? I said, what? They said, heat was coming out of you. And all of us were feeling the heat around. We don't tap into this thing, no. That's exactly what Jacob did, where he gave them the picture and did that. So as we go into this worship session, Minister Dunsey, I want you to have listen to what I'm saying here. I want you to have a picture of the promises that you know God has given to you. Are you following what I'm saying here? Please understand this. When you bow before an image, if the picture is not right, that's the image you are, that's idolatry. So take the scriptures that you know and create that mental image, because God doesn't have a white beard. You understand what I'm saying? Oh, sitting down and then you are coming and it's like he doesn't know what's... Are you from saying? Yeah. Sometimes the pictures they've given to you about angels look like you are bigger than the angels. If you have the picture of an angel from scripture, one foot was in one ocean, the other foot was in... you understand the size of the beings we're talking about? So create that image right on the inside of yourself as we go into this time, all right, of worship. So let's just begin to, before I bring up Minister Dosey, just begin to worship in the spirit. Just be worshiping in tongues now, if you can speak in tongues, and just be makali be shandaba and begin to create that image there. Begin to create that image there. Of yourself out of that situation, of that promise fulfilled in your life, and just begin to sing in the spirit. Let's begin to worship. Don't sing in English, sing in the spirit. But we have to create a harmony in this place. But let it be in the spirit. Don't sing in English, in the spirit. Begin to sing in your tongue. And imagine the incense going up to the Father. As he says in the book of Revelation, thousands and thousands were worshiping in harmony. And the Bible says the ancients of days descended and the books were opened and judgment was given. Judgment was given. Sing in harmony there.
shall not pass away, shall not pass away. Every tongue in heaven shall declare your glory. Every knee shall bow in worship. Compile. You will be exalted. Yeah.
We'll
leave to you. Yeah. Kini Ode. Kini Ode. Kini Ode. Senona Para. You are here. Moving in a mist. I worship you. I worship you. Worship you. You are here. Moving in a mist. Silana Teparadia. I worship you. I worship you. You are here. Rearranging destinies. I worship you. Worship you. Why, Maker, Miracle Worker, Covenant Keeper, Light in the Darkness. That is who you are. That is who you are. The Lord spoke to me this morning. He said, I'm giving you a song. And when you get to Wolfberg, when the anointing is heightened, release the sound in the atmosphere. But this will be the response of my people, that when you sing, they are not going to be singing. They will be declaring words of faith that can literally move mountains. Kenneth Hagin 11:23, that's Mark 11:23. Assuredly, I say unto you, if thou believe that you shall hear, that this mountain be removed and cast into the sea. He said, if you do not doubt in your heart, you will have exactly what you said. Zechariah 4:7, what the mountain before Zerubbabel, you shall become as a plain. Anytime I sing the song in this conference, break it up. Anytime I sing this, the next song in this conference, your response is to declare the word. He said to me, once the anointing is heightened, release the sound and let my people declare the word. Okay, hola. Okay, well. You still don't get the drift. Yours is not to sing. My assignment is to sing. Yours is to declare. Anytime you hear me declare the song in this conference, open your mouth and release scriptures. Words of faith. Okay, hola. Okay,
Lift your hands, my God.
Just lift your hands to him. This is holy moment. When God walks in on us, every gaze is on the Lion and the Lamb. Can you lift your hands and close your eyes to him? Let's just honor the King in this house. So it shall be that you will hear a voice as in the night when the holy solemnity is kept. I believe we've kept the holy solemnity. Now it's time to hear his voice. When the glory comes, there'll be no words to say. To him is a form of worship. When the glory comes, there'll be no words to say. Oh, when the glory comes. One more time, lift your eyes and tell him.